And we're back. So, last time we were able to lift the siege of Cordoba and defeat the Vandal besiegers. We were attacked at Lepcus Magna by the Berbers, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that. I have to get some forces together, really. And see what I can do about these Berbers. Also, because there's a giant Berber armor near army near Hippo Regius there. Huh. In any case, Syracuse is also ready to rebel due to its high population growth and small garrison. But on the bright side, Iberia is looking better than it was before. Northern Italy's a mess. I kind of want to give the barbarians another turn to fight each other here in this area because it seems like the Alans are trying to make a beeline out of there. And who knows, maybe the Visigoths will fight the Alemanni for me. And in any case, the Emperor is also besieging Narbo after having taken the capital of the Gallo-Romans. So, yeah, hopefully, my army here in Iberia will be able to start consolidating this area in southern Iberia. And the Emperor will be able to come down to Iberia and we can defeat the Suebi and the Vandals. And perhaps once I beat these barbarians in northern Italy, I'll send an army to fight the Berbers in Carthage. In any case, let's end the turn and see what happens. Okay, so the Gallo-Romans are fighting back. And that's good. That'll mean that means I'm going to take Narbo even faster. Okay. So let's start the deployment. This will be a great battle if we can really quickly take care of these armies here. That'll be really great. And then we can quickly move the Emperor to safer territory. But in any case, let us set up our infantry. Our positioning is not very good here. But let's put some cavalry on the left and the right. Have the Emperor set up in the middle. And let's move forward. And let us get our horse archers in there quickly to start harassing everyone. And who knows, maybe our horse archers will be able to defeat most of the tougher enemy units before they even engage with my troops. Let's get our cataphracts up on better turf here. So our horse archers have engaged. That's nice. These Veterani are nice units. They're charging at my horse archers. They're brave. In any case, my cataphracts look like they're ready to hit these lancers. And I'll have the Emperor charge at them as well. So these Germanic lancers will get swallowed up by cataphracts and lancers. And oh, that charge was pretty damaging, but I believe this cataphract charge right at their rear is going to really take them out very well. Let's take a look at it. They're already done. They're already done. Okay, the enemy candidati are charging. Let's get the Emperor in there. Move our cataphracts to flank. Okay, so let's get our cavalry to start assisting our infantry. Okay, let's charge with our cataphracts in the flank. Oh, these guys are tough. Okay, these infantry troops should be defeated soon. And let's get our equities to hit these missile units. Let's see this lovely charge of the equities. Yeah, those guys are done. Okay, so our cavalry is ready. Let's get them into position.
A true Roman has fallen in battle.
We got him, Constance.
Dead upon the battle, upon the field.
So the enemy does have that unit of veterani here pursuing my horse archers, but my horse archers should be able to defeat them. It seems like this part of the enemy army is done. Let's set up our infantry. Let's get our cataphracts ready. Set them up to flank. And let's double check on our horse archers. We should be doing more damage to these guys, considering I'm firing on them from two different angles. Okay, so the enemy Germanic lancers are coming around the side. Let's move against them with our equities. And this should end quite quickly. The Gallo-Roman Germanic Lancers don't stand a chance against my supported heavy spearmen there. And with my half cataphracts, this should be over quite soon. All right. So let's fast forward here. Alright, the other enemy general is done.
The gods be praised! The enemy's hearts are full of fear and now they flee!
And let's finish them off. And that should do it. Okay, so we lost a little bit of infantry, I think, when their cavalry charged down the hill. I could have handled that a little better. But in any case, another clear victory. And Narbo is ours. Okay, our navy won again. Okay, Narbo is ours. Let's check on the public order. It's not very good. So, since I'll enslave the populace. Okay. Okay, that's good. We have rioting in Syracuse, which is unfortunate. But I can't do anything about that, unfortunately. So we have the largest realm on the whole map. That's nice. We're slowly but surely rebuilding the Western Roman Empire. And some good news here is that this city, Toledo, it rebelled to me. It rebelled from the Vandals. So, that's great. That's great news. So now let's, so the Emperor's army in Narbo is not quite up to snuff. So the Gallo-Romans, they do have enough troops to launch a good counterattack, which is not the situation that I want to be in. So let us put these armies together. And I would actually like to hook up with the Emperor here in Narbo and get the Emperor's army to combine with this army here in Iberia. But let's check on Toledo. So Toledo's... that's not looking good at all. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this rebel army that I just got, and I'm going to take them out of the city, and I'm going to go take this city from the Hispano-Romans, and I'm going to have the emperor come here and lead this new great army. It does have a bunch of levies in it. I'll probably disband them once I take Tarraco. But in any case, that's good news, and that actually frees up this army that's in the south here. And it frees up the army so that I can go take Gades. So once I take Gades, then southern Iberia will be fully under my control. And I can concentrate on beating back the Suebi and the Vandals slowly, because it seems like their strength has been very much depleted, except for this full stack of Suebi here and this full stack of Vandals. But let's hope that they take out their anger on each other. But that's looking good in any case. So in the north here, it seems like the Visigoths are going somewhere else, and the Alemanni have retreated, actually. So that's all great news. Who knows? Perhaps the Visigoths will go settle over here or something. I mean, they did create a kingdom in Gaul and Hispania, so I mean, that's not out of the realm of possibility for them. But in any case, let's take out this rebel force. In any case, that's very good news for our armies. And actually, it seems like the Alans are making a beeline away from northern Italy, which is good. But it seems like we do have to come to the aid of Carnuntum after all. So let us get our troops in position. Okay, so our troops are in position now to fight the Langobards. They do have, let's check on their army here. They are pretty strong, but I think my army is pretty good too. So let us fight the Langobards at Carnuntum. All right. So I did have a little bit of a problem here. So I'm going to do the same things I did before I had the crash. This is actually the first time I've had a crash in this mod. But it happened right when I attacked this Langobard army. And if I'm not mistaken, it has to do with these archers. So perhaps I'll leave those archers somewhere else to avoid such problems. And I'll go attack the Langobards anyway. Because who needs those archers? So let's get these Langobards with no crashes. And thank you to my YouTube follower, to my subscriber, who was able to warn me about those archer units, because I just loaded up this battle with no problem. So the problem was 100% that archer unit. But in any case, I have Dalmatians, my favorite cavalry unit. You'll remember their exploits from the episode The Sack of Rome. So I've got my infantry ready up the middle. I've got my cataphracts ready to support. And let's see my reinforcements. This is hopeful news indeed. Okay, my reinforcements are coming. So that's nice. Let me check on these units here. These are horse archers. Very good, Roman horse archers. Go harass. Go harass them, please. Who's ready? most of them are actually coming to support right now. So that's nice. Okay, so what have they got? I haven't fought Langobards before, and they have long beards. So that's not unusual. What else do they have? Veteran swordsman. Levy spearmen, horde berserkers. Yeah, seems like normal unwashed barbarians. Mostly. So I'll just have our horse archers continue to harass them. But in any case, I've got a bunch of units are ready to join the battle. So that's nice. Okay, these slingers are ready, so I'll get these slingers up to support my infantry. Actually, I'll put them here because it looks like the enemy's coming forward, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so these infantrymen, I'll set these guys up over on this right flank there. And I'll move some cavalry units there on the right to flank. I have more Dalmatians. That's exactly what I wanted. Okay, let's put our slingers out front the way I wanted to have them before. And yeah, it seems like everything is pretty much set up the way I want. Yeah, these Langobards are not very strong against horse archers, which is nice. Interesting looking units there. In any case, let's move forward. Or I'll have some of my infantry be in the back. So let's set up this infantry like that. And we'll have some reserves. So I'll finally have my infantry set up in a way that doesn't make subscribers angry. Okay. So the horse archers are doing quite a bit of damage, it seems. And they do keep moving away from me. So it seems like the Langobards don't really want to fight. And I don't really blame them because I have both the infantry advantage and the cavalry advantage. So let's get my cavalry set up on the left, my heavy cavalry. Our cavalry on the right. Okay, so the enemy has horde raider cavalry harassing my horse archers there, but that's fine. I mean, if that's what they want to do, that's fine with me. Yeah, they're taking a lot of damage anyway. So I have a javelin cav ready to provide support as well. Let's see how much damage we can do to those lancers there. And get the cavalry set up on the right. And let's bring back the horse archers to harass. Our infantry is still coming in a bit more slowly than I'd like. Bring our cavalry a bit closer to make the AI confused and upset. Bring the slingers up. Let's charge at the horde cavalry because my equities surely will be able to defeat them quite easily in melee now that they've lost so many troops. And yeah, there you have it. There you have it. They're getting destroyed. Okay, so we have horde mounted warriors there. They're moving in against my cavalry, so I'll have my Dalmatians and my Germanic Lancers move in to get them. I'll have my equites do a counter charge. And I'll move my other unit of lancers to the right here. So the enemy has another unit of horde raider cav. But it seems like they're not coming out to face me. I mean, it wouldn't be smart of them to do that, because I'd be able to beat them quite easily. But in any case, let's move our infantry to engage. So the enemy has not made a proper battle line, which is normal. Let's get our supporting infantry involved a little bit. And I'll have this unit of Limitani as a reserve. Move our cataphracts a bit closer to get ready for the inevitable cataphract charge. And yeah, the enemy horde mounted warriors have been crushed. Get my cavalry ready. My infantry are coming to charge at these guys here. Okay, so their Langobard archers are just running around here, it seems like. Okay, my infantry are coming in to engage. Let's see what the Horde Raider cavalry does here. Okay, let's have our infantry run. Start running. Let's have our cataphracts charge. Let's have our Germanic Lancers charge. Our equites as well. Let's support our infantry. And I think this battle should be over soon. Okay, so their berserkers are in bloodlust and oblivious to the world, which is normal. Yeah, our charge was able to really break them here.
Press forward so the spirit of his army is broken too.
Okay, so the enemy flank here, the left flank, they have broken. That's very good. Let's set up the lancers for another charge.
And now his men fear us.
The enemy general is slain, which is very nice. Let's have our cavalry come in for another charge. Let's see, what part of the enemy line is still holding? Seems like they're still somewhat holding here, which is unfortunate. Let's move our cataphracts back. Let's move our cataphracts back and get them ready for another charge there. Okay, so our cavalry was completely successful on this flank here. So let's have our Dalmatians get into position. Let's have our Dalmatians get those javelinmen, actually. And our cataphracts can come help too. And we'll have our horse archers get in on the fun there against the javelins. Our tribal sword warriors took quite a bit of damage there, unfortunately. Interesting, let's get our cavalry out of there and into a better charge position. Okay guys, let's set you up back here, and this charge should pretty much end this battle. Let's get our guys back. Okay, now let us charge and finish off these guys once and for all. Okay, cataphracts, let's take a nice look at this cataphract charge. Very good charge there. Okay, so the enemy is routed there. Our Dalmatians have charged in a good sequence. And let us charge with the Lancers here. Okay, that was nice. Okay, very good charge there. Okay, so it seems like the enemy is mostly defeated here. Let's cycle my guys out one more time. Let's have our candidati hit this tribal warband there. Very good charge. Oh, these guys are strong, this tribal veteran warband. Okay, let's set up our other Dalmatians on the other side there. Yeah, I'm not going to underestimate these Langobards again. Okay, these guys are finally routing. Let's give them some room to run.
The gods be
Okay, so let us finish these guys off here. And that was not the easiest battle. They were tough. They were tough, I'll give them that. Again, my infantry was definitely not superior to theirs. Their infantry packed a punch. But in any case, their long beards were no match for the Western Roman army yet again. Yeah, the enemies there are gonna run. So yeah, a clear victory. All in all, a clear victory. We did lose a bunch of troops, but they lost their whole army, pretty much. And their captain. But in any case, the siege of Carnuntum has been relieved, which is very good. So unfortunately, well, actually my army here is not so bad, so I can still bring an army out of Carnuntum and Aquincum and get them to support any city that's attacked here in the east. So the east is looking pretty good. The Alans seems like they're getting out of here. They're hightailing it out of here. The Visigoths seem to be leaving. So all of that is good news. All of that is very good news. In any case, the other thing I was doing that I lost before I had the crash due to those archers was this unit, this rebel army that's in support of me. I'm going to send these guys to besiege the Hispano-Roman city there. And then I'll have the emperor come with a small force and lead these troops. And then with these troops, maybe I can pretty much finish the reconquest of Iberia, because it looks like these barbarians have weakened significantly. But in any case, let me get this army together and attack Gades. I'll get my army there to besiege Gades. There are only a couple of units in there, so this army should have no trouble taking it. Tingis is not in a very good public order situation, which is unfortunate. Perhaps I have to think of what to do. In any case, the Berbers look like they're ready to launch an assault of Lepcus Magna. They have a lot of missile units, and I don't, which doesn't bode well for that battle. But in any case, the other thing that doesn't bode well is Syracuse. And it looks like Syracuse wants to rebel. So I think what I'm going to have to do is pull this army out of the city, let it rebel, and then bring a big army from Italy and take Syracuse back. And then move that army using this navy. Move them into North Africa to retake anything I lose to the Berbers there. Imperator. So in any case, yeah, things are not looking so bad. Things are not looking as bad as they were before, in any case. So let's end the turn and see what the AI decides to do here, because I'm not sure what's going to happen. Let's see. Okay, so the Vandals have besieged Cordoba again. They've taken back Toledo. But I mean, it's realistic if you think about it. There were rebel armies that were switching sides all the time. So if that bandit army in Iberia wanted to pledge its allegiance to me, then, you know, that's not so out of the realm of possibility. Okay. So the Berbers... Yeah. Yeah, there's nothing I can do here. I mean, I don't have anything to defend against them. But you know what? We have to try. We have to try. I like this quote appearing here. A good general not only sees the way to victory, but he also knows when victory is impossible. But he also tries, even when it is impossible, to do as much damage as he can. That'll be my addition to Polybius here. Okay, so let's get ready to rumble. So I've got one unit of missiles here. That's fine. I have levy spears. And I've got Leite spearmen with shield wall. Perhaps I can do a bunch of damage to them as they're trying to break through. Or after they break through. They have quite a lot of cavalry, that's for sure. But let's fast forward here. Don't hold out much hope for this one, guys. Okay, so they are approaching. Well, I suppose we can at least take a look at the lovely units. The lovely Berber units here. With their peanut shields. Okay, so what I should probably do is set up my Leite spearmen in front of the gate. And perhaps the levies in front of this left breach here that's going to happen. And then my javelinmen, perhaps on this right breach. And then I suppose that'll leave the slingers to hold the breach on the very right side. But in any case, let's set up our Germanic lancers to at least flank and do as much damage as we can. Please move quickly, javelinmen. Oh, they've already broken down the gate. So guys, set up in shield wall formation there. Move forward. Hold the gate. Guys, don't have pathfinding issues right now, please. 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 What are you doing? Oh. Oh, God. Okay, it looks somewhat okay. Yeah, it looks okay now. Anyway, seems like they're just kind of looking. Hey, maybe the AI broke. That would be nice. This wall doesn't look so good. Are my guys having pathfinding problems there too? Guys, what are you doing? Could you please tell me? This is not okay. This is not okay at all. Okay, Javelin Man, if you don't want to help.
The gods have frowned on us today. The enemy have broken through the wall.
Guys, if you don't want to help, don't get in the way. Guys, you fools. Okay, Germanic Cav, do some damage. Yeah, that's the most best charge I've ever seen. Okay, my Javelin Men have gone completely crazy. My levies have already been completely overwhelmed. My Leyte Spearmen are actually doing pretty well. And that's what it looks like to hold off the barbarian invasion.
Look to the inner defenses.
At least until they flank you.
The gods have abandoned us.
Yeah, this doesn't look very good. Let's at least get our cav to damage as many of their spearmen there as possible, or slingers. But yeah, this is what barbarian invasion is all about. Lovely looking town, Lepkis Magna. You know, they produced a lot of olive oil for the Roman Empire. I wrote a paper about it once. Tripolitanian olive oil. That's what I'm thinking about right now. Maybe after this I'll make some pasta. That'll really cleanse the palate of what we're viewing here. This is not good. You can see the green slowly overwhelming the last bits of red on the map. But, yeah, let's fast forward this because there's no amount of tactics that will save us this time. My Germanic cavalry is actually... Well, they were doing well before that moment, but they weren't doing that badly. Okay, the last bits of red are being overwhelmed, but, you know, we got 714 guys. Considering I just had some levies and some random Germans and Mauritanians, that's not so bad. And the Mauritanian cavalry is pretty good, and the Germanic lancers... they're not bad. I like them. Okay, so Hadrumentum has been besieged by the other Berber army, but my army there is pretty strong. Okay, so we've got a couple of cities with problems. Syracuse. And Toledo. But Toledo is no longer under our control. So I don't care about that. So let's besiege Tarraco. And I'll get the Emperor, actually, and a couple of cavalry units. To support this captain here. Okay, Narbo is okay. I'll repair the governor's palace once I have more money. But actually, things are looking good. My economy's almost back in black. The emperor is going to besiege Tarraco with a pretty good army. Things are not looking so bad. Let's get this smaller horse archer unit to help the emperor as well. So if we assault... Yeah, Gades is ours. Okay, so Gades has really bad public order. I should have actually, taken it normally. But in any case, Tingis is also not looking so great. I have to start forming a new legion for North Africa, really. And Iberia as well. Okay, so it seems like the Eastern Romans have retaken some provinces. But in any case, the Alans are still confused, but one of their armies got out of this quagmire here in the north, and the Visigoths have completely gone after the Alemanni. So that's great. So please, I invite you to fight each other. Lepcus Magna occupied. Our economy is looking good. Much better. We're going to have 8,000 in profit. That's a combination of taking a few rich settlements as well as losing a lot of troops. But Syracuse is a big problem here, so I have to take these levies out of Croton. Be another unit as well. And then if I put these guys in Syracuse, it doesn't help. I just need more troops. Okay, so I will think about what to do in Syracuse, but all things considered, the situation in northern Italy has really stabilized. So I'm going to take Bonifatius's army, and we've got a push against the Gallo-Romans. If we can really crush this Gallo-Roman rebellion in the bud, well, not in the bud, but if I crush them, that'll be really great for the economy and for stability, because that'll really entrap these Vandals here, and the Suebi. And I'll have Gaul completely under my control. So yeah, two cities from the Gallo-Romans have been taken. Tarraco is going to be taken from the Hispano-Roman Rebellion. Gades has been taken, though how I'm going to hold it, I don't know. I think, okay, I've got to reshuffle these guys just a little bit. I'll take these Germanic Lancers, maybe these smaller units, move them to Tingis, get them in the blue. Rusadir is doesn't have great public order at the moment. But all things considered, let's get these guys to Gades as quickly as possible. Nova Carthago. Public order is not so bad. I can at least get a couple of tribal veterans over to Gades as well. Oh, but I have to beat these Vandals. So let's fight these guys. I think I can just beat them. Oh. That's interesting. Victory! Well, that was my fault. That was my fault. Anyway, I have a crisis on my hands, but I'll see you guys next time.